Rick, thanks for joining us on Jerusalem Dateline. You wrote recently that this time is one of the most important times to be praying since World War II. What did you mean by that?
I meant there's a global warfare. Many times people just look at what's going on in their country or one or two countries, but there really is a global spiritual warfare going on that I believe is the greatest since World War II. At that time, they were being barraged with news day after day of Hitler getting another victory, of him beginning to exterminate the Jews, and it looked like there was no way to stop him. If you just went by what you saw in the news at that time, it seemed totally hopeless, and why even pray? What good will it do?
You mentioned Rhys Howells. Why was he so instrumental in World War II, and what's the lesson for today?
He was the head of a Bible college in Wales, and they had really learned in intercessory prayer not to just pray in reaction to what you see on the ground happening around you or in the news, but to wait on the Lord in worship and prayer until you could really begin to have God's perspective and begin to find out what does God want to do in the future. So, for example, in World War II, when it looked like it was all over, that Hitler was really decisively winning, the Lord showed them to pray that Hitler would go into Russia. As a military man, he should have known better than to go into Russia with a lot of his troops right before winter. But he went in. They prayed that he would not be able to take Moscow quickly as the news was predicting. And Hitler just got stuck in the snow and it severely crippled everything else he did. And from there on, that was the turning point of World War II.
Rick, you talk about five phases of prayer. The first two are about intercepting World War III and a time of war and a time of peace.
I felt in 2017 that the Lord spoke to my heart that there was going to be great harvest coming in places like Iran, Saudi Arabia. And I felt like he said when that would begin, Satan would try to cut it off the same way he did with World War I, which occurred right after the great outpourings of the Holy Spirit in Wales, in Azusa Street, in Korea. There was a great missions movement of young people from universities going in large numbers. And then Satan succeeded in stirring up World War I, and young people who would have gone into missions instead were sent into the war and died in the war. And I felt like this Lord said, don't be ignorant of Satan's schemes. He will try to start a World War III when the harvest begins. And you are to encourage people to pray that that be stopped in the way that Rhys Howells saw World War II come to an end. Hmm.
In the next two phases, Rick, you talk about geographical areas, Taiwan and the South China Sea. And also you talk about the capitals here in this region, Ankara, Tehran, and Moscow. Talk about those.
I felt the Lord began highlighting that already in 2019 very clearly to us, that there would be an evil alliance forming between Ankara and Tehran and Moscow. Right after the Lord showed us that, they're traditional enemies. It didn't make sense that those three would work closely together. Right after the Lord showed us that, a week later, they met in Ankara with the three from the three foreign ministers of those nations. So I believe there's something evil, but it's we're not fighting flesh and blood. We're fighting against principalities and powers, but principalities use personalities. And so we need to cut it off at that level. And I felt the Lord showed the same thing would happen in China, that China would begin by moving on Taiwan. And if that was not stopped early on, it would grow into a regional war. And if those two regional wars happened at the same time, they could spin out of control into a World War III.
You talk about the mantle of Rhys Howells. What did you mean by that?
The mantle was this understanding and revelation that we're not to just pray to according to what we see with our eyes or think with our minds or our political opinions, but that we're to worship and pray until the Lord begins to show us things as he sees them, because he's delegated authority on the earth to the believers. And we are to pray and proclaim his will upon earth as it has already been decided in heaven.
And finally, Rick, what are you there at Succat Hallel praying right now?
Well, we're praying, obviously, protection over Israel. We're praying protection and grace in the Middle East, that it not turn in, if there's any kind of military action necessary with Iran, that that would happen quickly and decisively and within God's boundaries, preferably covert warfare, to stop their nuclear bomb plans rather than an overt warfare, and to pray that the harvest will continue to go forth in a great way in Persia, in Iran, and in the Middle East. And also we're praying much that this is a season where we believe God is stirring up the Jewish people to come home from places like New York, where there's such an anti-Semitism being expressed right now. And when they're here, then Ezekiel 37 says that once the bones are connected, God will begin to breathe upon them by his Holy Spirit. And that's where your listeners can pray for that breath of the Holy Spirit for the north, south, east, and west upon this land.
Well, Rick Ridings, appreciate your article and your exhortation to be praying at this very important time.
Always a joy to be with you, Chris. Bless you.